Extreme weather is also creating a water crisis in Mississippi's largest city. The huge winter storm that devastated much of the country last month has also left Jackson, Mississippi, without drinkable water for the past 2 weeks. The National Guard was called to Jackson to distribute water to its 160,000 people, and our Janet Shamlian is there.
Eddie Mitchell's been coming to this distribution site for 2 weeks to get these jugs filled with water he can't even drink.
Just for flush. We don't wash dishes with it or nothing.
The 75-year-old veteran is among thousands in Jackson about to enter their third week without full access to water.
How hard is it on people here?
Some people that don't have don't have a vehicle to come get water. Be here at 5:30 or 6 this afternoon when the line stretches around the corner.
There's such desperation. Some drivers, seeing the spouting pipe, pulled off a busy road to fill buckets. The entire city, whose residents are 82% black, is under a boil water notice. The unprecedented mid-February freeze strained Jackson's aging system. Dozens of pipes burst. Charles Williams is the public works director.
What is the status of getting water back to the people in the city?
Well, we feel like a majority of the city has received water pressure back, so that is a good thing. But we are concerned about our residents who live farthest away from the plant.
City leaders say it could cost more than $2 billion to fix the infrastructure in a city with a $300 million budget. Communities nearby dealt with similar outages after the storm, but Jackson is the only Mississippi city still struggling with water weeks later.
The city wasn't prepared, and there was no warning about there not being water. It just stopped working unexpectedly.
Summer Williams, 8 months pregnant, wants more definitive answers for her growing family.
Because I'm due soon, and only thing that's on my mind is how I'm going to handle it when the baby gets here.
As the city works to repair water main breaks, Jackson's mayor says they need help from the state and federal government to update the system. But the people we've talked to here say they need a different kind of help. They feel like they are not seeing the mass distributions of drinkable water that they've seen in other cities. Anthony?
2 weeks without drinking water. Janet, thank you very much.